I was the head miller for a house sawtry. They sell breaders and stuff like that, and I milled the corn. I was the head miller. I had gotten a bad cough one day from just some dust that was flying around. And I went home and just coughed real bad and hurt. And I coughed up some blood. And that was the red flag for me. And so I go and get a PET scan. I was driving home. My doctor called me. And that's when he told me I had stage 4. Lung cancer with metastasized in my head, my brain, and I had 5 tumors in my brain, 4 in my lungs, 1 on my adrenal gland, which is the one I still have left, but that's about the size of what the cancer was. I served in the Navy for 4 years, from 1992 to 96. And I was on board the USS Phoenix, SSN 702, out of Norfolk for 3 years.
Veterans deserve world-class service, and they deserve that wherever they are in the country. So the pharmacogenomics is not looking at the tumor, but looking at the patient's own DNA, and that's to help decide drugs across a whole broad array of therapeutic areas, not just oncology drugs. In fact, oncology drugs are a minority, so this is really to help the prescription for cardiology drugs and mental health drugs and pain medications and GI drugs, so acid-reducing drugs and a whole spectrum of other things.
I believe that this is going to help a lot of people, because I can imagine people getting the right amount of medicine for each thing that's going on, all because they're doing this testing.
Mr. McGuire has been through a lot. As we now look out beyond his cancer and think about how to support him, that's where I think this type of testing is really gonna make a big impact. So a patient would go to their local VA where the blood would get drawn, would get handled in a facility like the one that's behind us, packaged up and shipped to Sioux Falls, South Dakota, where the Sanford Imagenetics Laboratories will analyze that data and then report back to that facility the genetic information for that individual patient, where then would get incorporated into the patient's electronic health record and made available to each of their providers, so that genetic test results are available before they start a prescription, so that we can make those better decisions in real time.
I don't want to leave anytime soon. I love my wife and my daughter, my family, my church. I think I've still got so much left to give.
Mr. McGuire is truly a survivor, and we're grateful to have him here with us. I wish that every veteran would have access to this testing. There's, of course, over 9 million of them that get their care at the VA. So this will be the first step towards that process, and I hope that at the conclusion of this program, we'll be able to expand testing to even more veterans, so that even more of them can get the benefits of the testing, and we can give back to them in the way that they gave to us.